Hi, this is Andrew Chen here with AsiansOnFilm.com, and next to me I have the lovely and talented Marie Jamora. She's the director and co-writer of What Isn't There, which is screening here at the LA Asian Film Festival. So Marie, tell us a little bit about the movie.
The movie is about a boy who stopped speaking after seeing something very traumatic when he was a kid. And it's years later, he comes home for Christmas, and he falls in love for the first time. And it's set against the backdrop of the local indie rock scene in Manila. So it's about like young people, it's about family, and about moving on and falling in love.
Very cool. All these elements that everybody can relate to.
Yeah. Universal, a little bit.
So what inspired you to create this story?
I'd always been interested in the idea of identical twin brothers, and if one would lose his identical twin, traumatized. I'm sorry, I want to do that again. Like, I was always interested in the idea of twin brothers, identical twin brothers, and if one loses the other one, how traumatized one would get in the point of electively stopping the talk. And what would it take somebody who does that to speak again? And that was the idea.
Now, have you met somebody that this has happened to? Is this kind of based on true events?
I have never met anyone like that. But I guess imagination and just reading lots of books when I was young. I have aunts and cousins who are twins, but I had never, I guess I've always wanted a twin, and those are the things that came to my mind.
Okay, wonderful. Now, what do you want the audience to take away from the film when they're finished seeing it?
I really do believe that Filipino music, especially indie rock music in the Philippines, is the best music in the world. And what I want them to take away is basically about the healing and the good feeling you get when you hear beautiful music, because I think that music is universal. Our character stops speaking and music becomes his voice. So I do think that that's one thing. And I do want them to also have that feeling of when you did fall in love for the first time and how did that feel, and to sort of revisit that.
Okay. So music is definitely a big part of your life and a big part of this movie as well. How did you go about selecting the soundtrack for the movie?
Me and my co-writer are also co-music supervisors. So as we were writing the movie, we were actually also exchanging music because we had been doing that since college. We were friends since college. And so that was really nice because we would talk about, like, we love this band, or I've been writing this scene to this band. And then we set a lot of the movie in real life gig places, bars and stuff. So we really got the bands to come in, play the songs live. We recorded it for the soundtrack, and then we also released the soundtrack. So we have a soundtrack on vinyl. So that took around 6 months also to make. Oh. So the vinyl, the soundtrack is just as important as the script for us. And and in the Philippines, they stopped pressing vinyl for the last 30 years. So since our character loves music, he also loves records. And so I thought it was only befitting for him to have the soundtrack on vinyl. So I had it made in the United States, and we had to hand carry it back to the Philippines.
Oh wow. And was it difficult securing all the bands to perform for the film?
Yes, but I have a one-up, which is I'm a music video director, and I have been for the last 10 years in the Philippines. Okay. I've directed more than 40 music videos, and I have my own band. So in having my own band and being a drummer, these are my friends as well as the people I respect. So basically, you know, when you make a video for someone, it's like, oh, it's a favor card to you because I can't pay you, but you're making a music video for my band. Now I'm just like, I'm collecting those favors. I totally cashed in on the favors.
That's the way to do it for indie films.
Because people come up to me, they're like, how did you get these bands? And I'm like, make music videos for 10 years. That's how you're going to get the bands. All the information's on our website, whatisintthere.com. We're sellouts, so we have a Twitter, a Tumblr, Facebook, and stuff like that. So you can, if you're lazy, or I have an Instagram too. So I mean, I technically, we're covered.
Okay.